Hey everybody, welcome back to the Thinking Crypto channel. Guys, I've got some very bullish news for you. JP Morgan is going full capitulation. We know they've been offering banking services, financial services to crypto exchanges. Their analysts have been putting out information about Bitcoin price predictions. Now they're going to offer their wealthy clients the option to invest in their Bitcoin fund. Jamie Dimon, where are you at? Guys, we're going to break that down, why that's so significant. This is very bullish news. And we're going to talk about what other people are saying about it, like Barry Silbert and so on and so forth. Even we have news from Bill Miller on Bitcoin. We know he's a Bitcoin bull and he has some updated information. And we have a big Bitcoin adoption news here with Sean Culkin, if I'm saying his name correctly. He's an NFL player and he's going to get paid in Bitcoin 100%. And the Bahamas has launched their CBDC. We're going to talk about it, guys. Before we get into it, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button, leave a comment below, and hit the subscribe button if you're new here. It helps support the channel and it doesn't cost you anything. Guys, friendly reminder, I have a free weekly newsletter. Once again, 100% free crypto insights and knowledge. Be sure to sign up, link in the description. Let's take a look at the market here. Bitcoin is seeing some level of rebound. It's over $53,000. Ethereum over $2,500. XRP over $1.36. Binance Coin over $529. So we're seeing some level of rebound here. We'll see how this plays out. As I've been showing you guys on this chart here, the daily chart for Bitcoin, we're waiting for the consolidation and then the breakout upward. This green candle here that we see could be the breakout upward. I think the next target is 75,000. And as always, the altcoins follow Bitcoin's move. Don't let anyone lie to you and tell you that altcoins are decoupled from Bitcoin. They have not. Now, you know, Bitcoin will pump and then we'll have an alt season. So just keep that in mind. The more you understand about these market cycles and how things move, the better you can do your swing trades or whatever it is, you know, buying the dips or whatever it may be. But we follow Bitcoin at this point. And of course, I'm looking for $100,000 plus Bitcoin price according to the stock to flow model. And the altcoins, like I said, will follow. Well, guys, here's the big headline. JP Morgan to let clients invest in Bitcoin fund for the first time. The JP Morgan Bitcoin fund could roll out as soon as this summer. Sources tell CoinDesk, NYDIG will be the fund's custody provider. Guys, this is a huge capitulation. JP Morgan is the world's largest bank, and we know their CEO, Jamie Dimon, has been on record since 2017. And those of you who are here remember these statements where he called Bitcoin a fraud. He said it was stupid. He said you will lose your money. Let me play a clip here where they asked him about it at the the Institute of International Finance seminar.
Bitcoin hit a new high today.
I could care less what Bitcoin trades for, how it trades, why it trades, who trades it. If you're stupid enough to buy it, you'll pay the price for it one day. I've also told people that it can trade at $100,000 before it trades to zero. So tulip bulbs traded for $75,000 once, something like that. The only value of Bitcoin is what the other guy will pay for.
So many of you remember these states and many others. This was from October 2017. He called it a fraud before that. They kept asking him about it. He said, you're stupid if you invest in it. You lose your money. It's tulip mania. It's a bubble, et cetera, et cetera. He said a lot of fuddish statement, right? And now, look at this. Complete 180. His bank is now offering a fund for Bitcoin. They're providing financial services to crypto exchanges. Their analysts are putting out reports about it, giving price predictions, right? We've covered that ad nauseum on this channel. So it's amazing to see this. And of course, if they don't adapt to this innovation, this new tech revolution, this disruptive emerging asset class, they will go out of business. That's why you see Morgan Stanley is here, Goldman Sachs, and all the other major banks, Citibank, Bank of America, all of them are here, all the major hedge funds, and it's amazing to see this capitulation happen, guys. That's why you have to do your own research. Don't listen to just headlines. Don't listen to just what Jamie Dimon's saying on TV or what CNBC is saying. Look at the principles, the fundamentals, the technical analysis, and the news that are not making the big headlines, like who's adopting, who's building, who's getting patents, right? We've talked about so many different companies getting patents, even banks, like Bank of America has multiple crypto patents, guys. So I hope you see what's happening here and why this crypto market, this asset class is here to stay. All the big banks, all the major players are here. So let me give you some more details on this. The JPMorgan Bitcoin Fund, as they mentioned, can roll out this summer. JPMorgan's Bitcoin Fund will be actively managed, multiple sources told CoinDesk. That's a notable break from the passive fare offered by crypto industry stalwarts like Pantera Capital and Galaxy Digital, which let well-heeled clients buy and hold Bitcoin through funds without ever touching it themselves. Galaxy and NYDIG are now offering Bitcoin funds to Morgan Stanley. The JP Morgan fund will be for private wealth clients. So this is not your retail average JP Morgan Chase bank holders. This is for their whales, my friends. So this will be amazing to see this roll out. So the move by JP Morgan marks a sharp turn for the $3 trillion bank. So this is a complete 180, right? And here they talk about, you know, Jamie Dimon, where some of the statements and things he made in 2017. JP Morgan CEO Jamie Dimon called Bitcoin a dangerous fraud in 2017, threatening then to fire in a second any trader who touched the stuff. If you're stupid enough to buy it, you'll pay the price for it one day, he said at that time. And now he has bend the knee to Bitcoin and crypto. Remember, it starts with Bitcoin, and then they're going to offer Ethereum and XRP and Chainlink and so on and so forth. We've seen this story over and over with these different banks and investment firms who have capitulated, right? Guys, it puts a smile on my face to see Jamie Dimon have to do this and his bank after these statements. And I think Barry Silbert said it best. He tweeted this morning, looking forward to Jamie Dimon publicly admitting he was wrong about Bitcoin. I am waiting for that day. I think that's going to be just one of those great days to see Jamie Dimon have to really put his pride aside and talk about, yeah, we're offering Bitcoin trading now to our wealthy clients. We're offering financial services to crypto exchanges. Guys, needless to say, we are headed to new higher highs when it comes to price and adoption. We're still early in the adoption curve. And I'm not just talking about this bull cycle. This bull cycle will go up to $100,000 plus for Bitcoin and so on and so forth. But remember, there's going to be future bull markets, and mainstream investors are not fully in yet. You know, we're just probably 1% of the world that's paying attention to this crypto market. That's why you got to count yourself lucky you're here. This is truly an opportunity of a lifetime. There are no gatekeepers. You can have just $100 in Bitcoin, $100 in XRP, $100 in Ethereum, and you are part of the asset class. You don't have to be an accredited investor. And, this market is global. It is borderless. It doesn't matter if you're in Turkey or some country in Africa or in Iceland or in the United States or South America. You could be anywhere in the world. If you have internet connection, you can participate in the asset class, guys. That's groundbreaking. That's amazing because of the blockchain, right? If you really think about how big this is not just certain stocks in a specific country or countries. This is global. You could be anywhere and have access to Bitcoin as long as you have internet and obviously a mobile smartphone and things like that, and which the majority of the world does. So this is big, and people don't really understand how big this is going to be. This is not like Tesla's trading on the stock market just here in the United States. This is everywhere. So another big endorsement here for Bitcoin is from Bill Miller, who is, of course, a hedge fund manager. Fund manager Bill Miller says Bitcoin is not a bubble. BTC is entering mainstream as demand grows faster than supply. So a lot of people think we are maybe in bubble stage right now. But let me lay a few fundamentals and principles out. Every market goes into a bubble. Every market, real estate, we saw the real estate market pop, right? That bubble pop. The tech.com boom in the 90s to 2000 went into bubble phase and popped. We've seen the current stock market is in a bubble phase and people are expecting some major correction. So calling something a bubble doesn't mean that it doesn't have value or that it doesn't have long-term potential or it's not here to stay. You just have to understand the market cycles and play that market cycle, whether you're in real estate, stocks, whatever it is. There's bubbles in every market. Now, the crypto market entered into a bubble at the peak of December 2017. It corrected. But guess what? It's still here. And this bull market cycle, we are not in a bubble. We're not at the top yet. It will get to a bubble phase, and that's why I try to share the facts with you guys and go through the technical analysis and the market cycles, right? Like the stock to flow model, so that we can track it accordingly. We do not want to be buying the top. We want to sell the top, as you would in any market, whether that's real estate, stocks, and whatever it is else, right? So Bill Miller, the founder and chief investment officer at Miller Value Partners, does not think Bitcoin is a bubble. Instead, he said it is at the beginning of mainstream adoption. Remaining bullish on the cryptocurrency, the famed value investor explained that Bitcoin's price will rise as the demand for crypto is growing faster than its supply. And I absolutely agree with that statement. We're still very early in the adoption curve. And check this out. PayPal is seeing a huge influx of demand. So demand for PayPal's crypto offering exceeded all expectations, CEO said. In the next 5 to 10 years, there will be more changes in the financial system than over the past 2 decades, PayPal CEO predicted. So we know PayPal launched their crypto trading in 2020. They're seeing exponential growth around it. And they just, of course, launched it on Venmo because PayPal owns Venmo, and opening up crypto trading to millions of a younger demographic, which of course we know have gravitated to crypto versus the older demographic. So Dan Schulman, CEO of PayPal, said demand for on the crypto side has been multiple fold to what we initially expected. There's a lot of excitement, PayPal's president and CEO said in a Sunday interview with Time Magazine. So great to hear that. He also talked about the future of crypto and the digital economy. 10 years from now, you will see a tremendous decline in the use of cash. All forms of payment will collapse into the mobile phone. Credit cards as a form factor will go away, and you will use your phone because a phone can add much more value than just tapping your credit card, he said. Guys, that's what we've been talking about for years. The token economy, the digital economy, everything will be tokenized, and things will be QR coded and all that, where you won't even need cash or credit cards. Whether that's great or good or bad, whatever it is, that's another debate, but this is where we're headed. This is the digital economy. And as we've talked about, the trend with millennials and the younger demographic, they're growing up in a digital world. So this is going to be the norm for them. You know, for us who were maybe grew up before or born before the internet boom and the technological boom, and before social media, you know, we see the contrast here, and we may not like it. Like, I personally don't like, you know, I obviously use social media, I use YouTube, but do I love it? No. I grew up in the 90s where I was playing outside and I played video games here and there, but my time was spent outside, and my life was not digital. It was more of personal and being around people, right? But look, I can't be that old man of get off my lawn type of mentality. I have to see things change. Things change. That's how the life works. That's how the world works. And that's how you have to adapt to where you're at. And there's potential to make money because you recognize a trend that's happening. And that's what we're doing here, right? In getting into crypto early. So this is big. And check out this adoption news. So Sean Culkin, if I'm saying his name right, he's an NFL tight end. I'm trying to get an interview with him. He said, I fully believe Bitcoin is the future of finance, and I wanted to prove that I have real skin in the game, not just trying to make a quick buck. I will be converting my entire 2021 NFL salary to Bitcoin. Wow. And you know other folks are going to do it in other leagues, NBA, NHL, and so on and so forth. So this is big adoption news. And remember, these guys have a lot of huge followings. We saw Russell Okung do the same thing. And I think this is just the start. This is just the tip of the iceberg. We're going to see more on this front. Check this out, guys. So I don't want to play the clip here because it's CNN and I don't want to get any copyright strikes. But the governor of the Central Bank of the Bahamas was on CNBC with Julia Chatterley, and it looks like they have launched their digital currency, their CBDC, called a sand dollar. Guys, when I say the token economy and the digital world, look at this. We have small countries getting this live. Here's the gentleman, John Roll, if I'm saying his name right. And we know the United States is working on the digital dollar. I've interviewed Chris Giancarlo, who's working at the Digital Dollar Project. They're trying to get that going. We've seen the digital yuan in the wild with videos and images. So everybody's trying to create their CBDC. This will benefit crypto. It creates the digital ecosystem. And leverages, obviously, the technology behind crypto, which is blockchain. And it will further educate the masses. The government are going to educate the masses about blockchain and tokenization. And of course, that will make it easy for them to understand crypto, guys. So here's the next news. U.S. bank, State Street back, $30 million raise for institutional crypto builder Securrency. U.S. bank could be the proverbial one to watch in the digital asset space, says Security Chief Officer Strategy Officer Patrick Campos. So we're seeing mergers, acquisitions, all types of investments here into the crypto market. And I like to emphasize that because it shows the growth, the maturation, the emergence of this asset class. They're not just buying the tokens. People are building the infrastructure and there's investments in the companies that are building. And as I've stated many times, I wish I was an accredited investor because I'll be investing in these companies, right? So this is amazing, guys. So institutional cryptocurrency infrastructure firm Securrency has closed a $30 million funding round, backed by banking majors U.S. Bank and State Street. Announced Monday, the Washington, D.C.-based firm's strategic Series B also included Abu Dhabi Catalyst Partners and Wisdom Tree Investments, which participated in Securrency's $17.65 million Series A back in early 2020. Big financial firms and asset managers have warmed to crypto trading, but require some hand-holding when it comes to connecting legacy systems to digital assets in a smooth and compliant way. Guys, the building is happening. It's increasing. The money's being invested. This is why I'm so bullish. Not just the prices that we look at a coin market cap, because I know the prices will eventually follow. Just got to be patient. And there's still millions and billions, of people who are going to come into this market. We're still early, as mentioned. Finally, you guys know I hold Chainlink. I'm bullish on Chainlink. I'm looking for a $100 Chainlink price, eventually $1,000 long term. And here, it looks like they got some adoption news. So Iris Network, which is an interchain service hub for next-gen dApps or decentralized apps, they tweeted the following. Our research director, Jeffrey Hu, shared insights in Chainlink today, summarized Chainlink's Oracle is aligned with Iris Network's vision, supporting next-gen business decentralized apps with cross-chain and on-chain/off-chain interoperability. Looking forward to more collaborations with Chainlink. It's getting adoption. And that's what you want to see when you're invested in a token or project. I know some people just follow the speculation pump, but I'm not only following that, I'm following the utility and long-term adoption. And it's great to see Chainlink is getting this respective adoption. Guys, what do you think about this JP Morgan news with Jamie Dimon? It puts a smile on my face. I'm going to have a great night's sleep tonight knowing that Jamie Dimon is capitulating to crypto after all his BS FUD statements from years ago. Those of you who were here during that, it was pretty scary at the time, especially if you were new to crypto, because you got the CEO of the world's largest bank saying these things, right? We didn't have the adoption news that we're seeing today. I always tell you guys, I got in late 2016. You didn't hear about this hedge fund manager or this company saying Bitcoin's the best, we're investing it, we expect. That was not the case. You had a lot of FUD, and especially when it's coming from Jamie Dimon, and he's like, I'm going to fire anybody who's investing. It's amazing to see the capitulation. So leave your thoughts and comments below, hit the thumbs up button, share this video, and I'll talk to you all later.